Ladies and gentlemen, on my left, Lucas Clairbout, France. And on my right, Scott Evans, Ireland. Scott Evans to serve. Love all. Play.
Welcome back, everyone. We have on court now live home hero and defending champion, Scott Evans. Number 4 seed at this year's event, taking on, from France, Lucas Clairbout. In their previous encounters, Scott won in the Irish International last year in 2 sets. Close match, 21-17, 21-18, so this could be a hotly contested match today. I have with me for this match, Tony Murphy.
Evening, Alistair. We've been enjoying today's game so far.
I'm still recovering from Pablo and Vili.
I'd say Vili will be for a few days as well.
One.
But looking forward to this lineup. It was another Frenchman that Scott beat in the final last year. So it'll be another campaign to get this match out of the way, progress on to the later stages of the tournament.
Tricky match for him to get through. He's got to navigate some tricky matches in the earlier round.
Love.
Scott. But a good start so far. 2 love up.
Service over. 1, 2.
Have you had much experience playing either of these players, Alistair, during your time in the circuit?
I played Scott once, 2005.
I've
not really been much on the European tour for the last 5-6 years. I come back to European tournaments now and I don't know any of the European players. Had that problem last year's European Championship. Didn't recognize anyone.
4, 2.
So the Frenchman starting to take control here.
That's his strength, isn't it? The Scott Evans smash coming forward and freezy put away. Seen him do that quite a lot here last year and even in the first round earlier. He'll not be given that opportunity that often either, once the Frenchman realizes. That's where Scott gets his points from.
Service over. 6-3.
Again, I'm a little unsure on that last line call. Got just a little bit nervy, I think, here in front of the home crowd. Just needs to settle himself a little unsure.
Yep, just not comfortable yet inside the rally.
Just rushed his last lift there. Yeah, not enough height. Either play the net or just move it on, but with a little bit more height than I feel. That's a great anticipation at the net from Lucas. Takes us to a 9-4 advantage. Out.
10-4.
That's a great shot from
11.
Is Scott just not quite in this game yet, I feel, Tony?
Bit of misjudgment. There's a few shots he's been well capable of hitting, getting back into the court with a bit of interest, but he's decided to leave and they've landed in, as well as a few of his shots sailing at the sides in the back. So there's a lot going to be improved on. And I don't think this set's out of his reach just yet.
Reasonable deficit, though. He needs to start turning it around right out of the blocks now. Just needs to settle a little. I think he's just trying to finish points
court
a little
five,
bit too quickly. He's
risking
just a little bit.
That'll help.
That's a great cut.
Good touch. That's what he needs, the variety. He hasn't used much as much variety as possibly should have thus far. But the power smash, followed by a gentle cut, created the gap. Easy winner.
Sort
of the slam dunk of badminton, is it?
Having absolutely no luck in this match.
Quite uncommon to see service faults in singles, given that there's no real pressure.
I'm just watching the way the last half of the set has played out, and I still feel Scott is just forcing too much. He's not doesn't look relaxed to me. He's not sitting on the court as much as I think he should, and he's persevering with trying to find an attacking game that will work, but at the moment it's not working. needs to balance it, I think, a little bit with some safety and keep himself in the rallies, because a lot of the points that are going to Lucas are coming from Scott's hand.
Still seems a bit concerned about his last hold serve.
He was concerned about, I think he was concerned about Lucas's serve there. Lucas continues to extend his lead. Looks quite relaxed up the top there, working away. Scott needs to get him under more sustained pressure. Again, good pressure play. Very good pressure play from Lucas. He's keeping Scott in the back of the court, and Scott's trying to attack his way out of a defensive position, and it's just not working for him. I think the problem, Tony, with this haul is it is quite a slow haul. And there's a lot of players are... I think in Scott's instance, who are quite attacking and like to attack. And it's just, it's not that easy to get the shuttle on the floor in this hole. And I think you have to control your attack. I think because it's a slower hole, it's quite easy for what Scott's doing here. He's just over attacking and it's been used against him.
Yeah, I definitely agree with that. Even what we saw when he was defending, he was trying to whip everything back over Lucas's head, and shuttles aren't fast enough. It's not going where it needs to go. Playing a bit softer, both when he's attacking and even defending, if he cross blocks, straight blocks even, rather than trying to drive the shuttle back, is going to be quite important.
18-9.
Great smash.
Bit more angle on that one. He had the short lift. He had the jump smash, so he was able to put that one on the floor. Is that sailed long?
19.
Nope. Behind the line. Positive to see him still fighting, trying to find a way into the match before this sets over.
I'm just watching. You know, I just feel that he's still persevering with trying to find his his preferred game. He's going to keep attacking. Certainly, this will give. I think this game 13, is too far gone at the moment, but 19. This is certainly going to give him confidence going into the start of the second game. Surely, we're too far back now to turn this game around.
Service over.
I think that's the problem. That last rally 20. Indicates, for me, game all the problems point. That Scott's had in this 13. Game. He's trying to attack. Finds himself in low positions and then is lifting short.
Service over.
Showbutton coming on at the end. Nice trick shot, 15, even Lucas 20. Stunned at the net.
Scott's starting to play a lot more patiently, and I think because he already knows that this game is gone. But I wish that he'd started to play with this sort of construction earlier on in the game.
Game.
We need to see more rallies like that in this set.
First game won by Lucas Clairbout. 21.
Coach,
you know,
tripping up on his way on.
Court 5, 20 seconds. Court 5, 20 seconds.
Back here for the second set. Lucas, one set up. 21-15. Scott, very slow starting
second
in the first
game.
Set. Starting to play a lot better towards the end. A little bit too late, but with a lot more construction at the end of the first game and control of the rallies. I just think very rushed play from Scott in the first set. Maybe a little nervous, a little edgy. Hopefully we get to see the best of Scott now, because I don't think we saw it in the first set.
One.
That's a good start. 1-0.
Love.
used the cross block rather than a flick or a drive off one of Lucas's smashes, which opened up the court nicely. Be able to play the following shot into the gap. Great touch of the net.
Just more patience, you know, that we need to see longer rallies. I mean, Scott's strength, as you mentioned, Tony, is he's attacking play, getting to the net and finishing off rallies. And that's great if it's working. And if it's not working, you have to adapt. Can't persevere with it if it's not working.
Too slow to have a plan B in the first set.
I think just he seemed a little bit edgy. He seemed a little bit rushed. His body language was a little bit rushed in the first set. Seems to have more of a plan now. Scott starting to take a good lead in this second game. Lucas being told to return to the court. Play must be continuous in badminton. That's a great shot. Great fake from Scott there, Tony.
He's got the big smash and he's got the skills when he comes to the net. When you put them together, one off the other, it's a deadly combination.
Look, it's just starting to fall apart here. Much more controlled play, though, from Scott.
Nine.
There's no drift in this hole, but Lucas has managed to push everything out the back of the court.
Yeah, again, the hole's been quite slow for most players, and yet he's managing to find it outside the back line.
That's wide.
Great bit of flair there from Scott. Unlucky to not find the line. Two into the break. It's a huge lead that he's created for himself there.
Quite a contrast from the first set.
Ilan. 11-2. Play.
Scott just needs to keep his focus now. No silly errors. Because he has quite a comfortable lead. That you would assume is a bit much for a comeback in this set.
And that's the difference. Look at the difference in the scoreline.
Every shot's a lot more controlled. He's not.
Scott doesn't look under any. He doesn't look like he's uncomfortable playing this sort of game. And it doesn't look to me like Lucas is going to be able to hit. Two. 14-2 now to Scott. The hole just gets deeper and deeper for Lucas at the moment.
Scott now has the same points as he does now as he did in the first set, but in the first game, had 6 smash winners. In this game, just 3. So shows he doesn't need it to win points in this game. But he still has it. He needs it.
17-2.
I think the interesting statistic, if we can find it, is how many smash mistakes or attack mistakes that Scott made in the first game as he persevered with his game. And similarly, he didn't need it.
Want to predict the score for the second set?
I'm done with prediction. I'm sorry. I'm quite quiet at the moment. I'm still recovering from Pablo and Vili.
Service over. 18-4. 20. Game point, 4.
I think it's going to be 21-5, Tony.
Great timing.
How did I do?
Well, you're spot on, but you didn't tell me what you were betting for, so.
Just scaring you.
So starting this third set, I see no reason why it should be any different to the second set. Scott looked in complete control. Nerves obviously settled, game plan sorted. Lucas had no answers for.
Yeah, I don't think Lucas phased out or paced himself. I think he continued looking for answers. He just had none. But, you know, I always feel a third set, anything can happen. I think the game can change. That's the problem with that Scott may still have created
final
for himself by losing that first
Love
set.
Play.
Let's hope we see more of the same. And Scott can continue his progress in his 100th Carlton Irish Open.
Defending champion, as you mentioned at the start, but this year is different to last year's tournament.
Stronger this year.
Yeah, put up a grade from international
one.
Series last year to an international challenge.
Scott's still very much one of the players in the mix to win this event, but yes, a sterner test than last season. And I'm sure he believes he can win it. I think he can win this tournament.
Especially after the first seed being put out in the match before.
He has a great coaching support there behind the court for him. He has Tom Reedy and Erwin Saya. Keeping him calm. Seems to have controlled him quite well after his poor start in the first game. Whatever words of wisdom they had for him.
Of course, he went last year without anyone at the back of his court up until the men's singles final when Tommy Reedy came out. Give him that extra, the last push to get over the finish line. So quite an independent player, generally.
Three, one.
just right. Well, left. One. Scott. Good judgment.
Lucas must feel like he has to hit a line to get a winner at this point.
Hold out at the back of the court.
Let's see a few replays of that magic.
Ooh,
close.
Six, four.
Certainly done enough work to get into that position.
Great shot from Scott there.
Seven, four.
Gonna need to be careful in his length. Scott a bit shorter the past few rallies.
Scott just needs to be a little bit careful that he doesn't lose his sting. He was what he did very well in the second game was patience. He ran, he moved the shuttle around the court, but he was following it up with attack at the right times, and he's just a little bit too passive. A bit better, that's much better. He has to attack, he has to control when he does it. He has to be careful in this hall as well, because it is a little slow. And it can be used against you. And great timing.
Great anticipation.
Interval. Change ends, please.
Scott goes 11-6 up at the break.
He's continuing the tempo, trying to control the rally, like he did very well in the second set. Maybe slowed up a tad in the third, we got a bit relaxed having won such an easy second set.
Eight.
Scott keeps his length up like he was able to do in that rally. This really is just rally practice for him. He's able to just cruise around the court until he gets his one opportunity to finish the rally off. Winner of this match is going to play Lukas Schmidt from Germany, who has made it through two tough rounds, beating the 8th seed from Scotland, Kieran Merrilies, followed by Anton Yartsev from Russia, who was a qualifier. Again, easy pickings, going up after the hard smash down the line. That's 17, the speed of Scott coming into play.
10.
Being able to move forward after hitting the shuttle.
Ready to play.
Desperation there from Lukas, really off balance. Could have
18,
been in a bit of a better position to go for
12.
A smash of that par. Eight match points. Scott Evans.
12.
It's all over after 48 minutes of men's singles. Scott Evans beats the Frenchman in three. He'll be happy with his later ladder sets of the match. I think Klerbrook won't be too disappointed with the performance overall. Maybe ran out of a bit of steam and was a bit less experienced. So we look forward to an interview with Scott Evans now. Coming up straight after.
Scott, good to see you. And three games, a little bit shaky in the first, but you got to be happy the way you came out in that second and the focus that you showed to win that match.
Yeah, I think I had the wrong tactic from the start, actually. and he did come out quick, and he was playing well, and just I was just doing the wrong things, making some bad mistakes, giving him the chance too, way too easy. Then he got a big lead, 19-9, and then I started to change my tactic a little bit just to see what he would do. I did that, and I got back to 15 or so, and could feel that he was struggling. He has no real weapons unless I'm lifting flat and short, which I did a lot at the start. So once I got good height and good length on the shuttle, I don't think he put one smash down the rest of the game. So
little bit of delay on this court, hanging around a bit in the hall. Is that something that you find a little bit difficult to deal with at times? You'd rather, you know, be on time and have the matches on time.
Yeah, of course. Of course, you want to be on time. I mean, it's okay to, you know, it's quite easy. If you're staying close by, it's all right. You know, you can keep an eye on the scores. You can see, okay, five games to go. But I'm living with my mum and dad, and it's a 40-minute drive. So I drove out. I was here quite early. But it's okay. I can still sit in the hall, relax a little bit, and then get ready when I need to.
You're defending your title. Everybody knows that. Different level this year. But you got to be happy now with two matches under your belt and the way it's going.
Yeah, I'm happy with. I mean, been training with Peter since after the Worlds, and he's trying to change a couple of things in my game, and I was struggling with it at the start back in September and stuff. But I feel like things are coming together, and I really believe in what we're doing together. So it will take a little bit of time, but I feel good and I'm working hard, and we'll see how it goes this week.
Reasonable draw, has to be said. But Lucas Schmidt in the next round, I think the last time you played him, I think it was German Open, and you won on that occasion.
Yeah,
so that's you go into that match confident.
Yeah, I'll again, it'll be another tough opponent, and I'm going to need to be focused and play well. It's like every game here, if you're not focused and playing well, you're not going to win. So I'm looking forward to tomorrow.
All right, Scott, thanks for joining us straight after your match, and well played.
Thanks.
Time.